Hello and welcome. Have you ever wondered how to animate your points while working with the FFD Deformer inside of Cinema 4D? If you want to animate the position of the points themselves, well, today we're going to walk you through those steps. If you'd like to learn more about 3D modeling, animation, and all that good stuff, along with career tips, you can check out my newsletter in the description below as well. Let's go ahead and jump inside of Cinema 4D. So here you can see we have this lotus flower. We actually built this inside of Cinema 4D in an episode a while back. But you can see the settings haven't changed. They're the same as they were for the FFD. If I click on this here, you can see under object, we have grid size, grid points, and we walked through all of these and how they work in that episode. And I'll leave a link in case if you want to check that out. But we had built this flower and deformed it and created its shape using the FFD. Without it, all these petals are flat and rather boring, but the FFD deformer is what turns this into something a bit more. So animating these and their position isn't quite intuitive. You can move them around and, you know, if you just were to hit keyframe with it as default, nothing happens. Could move it back. We can hit keyframe again and nothing happens. So what's going on here? Well, I'm going to hit undo so that we have this back in its initial position and get rid of those keyframes. And I'm just going to move this back here to that general location. Now, a few things need to happen, and this actually is animated the same way as you would any points on any mesh. The FFD cage points animate the same way. And there's no mention of this in the manual or anything like that. So this is kind of something that isn't super intuitive and is hard to look up. So I'm really excited to be covering it today because I don't know if anyone else has. But basically, you want to turn on point level animation down here. It's this icon, really small. And that will enable you to be able to keyframe the points now. So now if I were to decide I am going to move these points and I am going to keyframe them. Now when I hit the keyframe button, it's actually going to create a keyframe and I can put this back at the beginning and I can hit the T hotkey for our scale and scale these in. I can even drop them down a little bit vertically if I want to, and then I can hit the record active objects. I call this the keyframe button. I'm just going to hit again. And if we hit play now, it animates. Now, this is a super, super boring animation. So how can we make this a little bit more spiffy, as I would like to say? Well, we can go into our window drop-down menu, go into our timeline, and you'll see I have this window open. Sometimes it opens up down here, depending on your layout. I might actually go ahead and put this here. But then we can make this a little bit bigger. And you'll see we have our FFD in here. If I hit that plus button, you'll see that we have position, scale, rotation. And that's for like the main axis of these objects being keyframed. But if you want to look at, we also have the grid points keyframed. So you'll see those in here. So that's the number of points in our actual FFD grid from the last episode. You'll know that. But then we have this new option down here, PLA, and that stands for point level animation. So this is really what's controlling the opening of this flower. So I can grab this keyframe here and bring it in closer. And now you can see that animation's happening a lot quicker from here to here. And you'll also notice that this is a linear movement. So it's not the most maybe interesting of options. So I'm actually going to click on both of these and I'm going to click the soft, set the selection keys to soft interpolation, and that'll change how the movement looks a little bit. You can adjust the easing of them. You can choose to have this ease in, We can choose to have this ease out. And if you hover over any of these buttons, they'll tell you what they do and also the hotkeys for them. So if you want to learn that stuff, you can go ahead and just hover and then you'll know. But this is still kind of boring. So the next thing you can do is you can actually adjust the bias here, and you'll see that in your attributes manager. I'm going to change my work area from 90 frames to something a little bit smaller since we're just focusing on this beginning portion. So when I adjust the bias, it's actually adjusting how these keyframes are weighted and the effect amount of effect that they're having. So you could see that how at 100% I'll click play, how that's a little bit different than if this was at 0 and I clicked play. You can see how it changes the look a little bit. So I'll increase that back to 100%. And you can feel like it has a little bit more of easing to it. And you can even put these in negative numbers, so you'll see that that really affects the bias for that first keyframe. So now it's blooming much faster. And there's something about this that just seems more visually pleasing to me. So I suggest messing around with this bias, messing around with some of these options up here. And it's a great way to learn and become familiar with all the keyframing tools in here. And I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you did, please hit like, please hit subscribe, ring that bell. And if you want to learn more things and check out my blog and just learn about 3D motion design, check out my newsletter. And I'll see you here next time on Ambient 3D Animations.